In this tutorial, I will show you one of the most powerful new features of paintcode, variables. With variables, it was very easy to make parametric drawings such as buttons with states, circular sliders, animated characters, and even never-before-seen user interface controls. Let's start with a simple button. This button is a rounded rectangle with a corner radius of 10 points. I'd like to make this button parametric so that I can easily change the corner radius of the button in my code. For this purpose, I'll create a variable. You can create many kinds of variables such as numbers, angles, text, booleans, etc. It is even possible to create a special expression variable which can depend on other variables. We'll explore expressions in the advanced variables tutorial. In this case, I will choose the number kind. Let's rename the variable radius and change its value to 10. I will now show you how to connect the radius variable to the corner radius attribute of the rectangle. Start by dragging the variable's connection dot, then connect it to the same attribute in the inspector, in this case, the corner radius attribute. Once the variable has been connected to the attribute of the shape, the text field of that attribute will be replaced by a special button in the inspector. I can easily change the value of the variable in the editing popover. As you can see, the corner radius of the button changes accordingly. When I want to disconnect the variable from the attribute, I can simply click on this purple cross. Once the variable has been disconnected, the corner radius of the button is independent from the variable. Now I'm going to show you an alternate way to connect variables with shapes. Instead of connecting the variable with an attribute in the inspector, I can connect it with the shape directly on the canvas. When I release the mouse button, a contextual menu is displayed. Here I can choose the attribute from which I want to connect the variable, in this case the corner radius. You can connect the variable to as many shapes as you like. Let me show you. I'll create another rectangle and connect the same variable to its corner radius too. When I open the variable editing popover, you can see that both corner radiuses of these rectangles change. You can change the value of a variable easily, even when the editing popover is closed. Simply hover over the value of the variable in this list, then click and drag the mouse up or down. Next, I'll show you how to make the title of this button a parameter of the generated drawing method. For this, I'll create another variable, but this time I'll choose the text kind. The default value of the text variable will be new title. Let's also change the name of the variable to title. Now I'm going to connect this variable with the text attribute of the button. This is very important. After we've added the two variables to our drawing, the method generated for this canvas now takes two parameters. The same holds for the generated style kit code. You can see that this method now takes two parameters, title and radius. These are the two variables we created a few moments ago. Now I'll show you how to draw the button differently when it's pressed. To do this, I will create a new variable called pressed. This will be a Boolean variable, which can be used to represent logical values. I'll now create a new shape by duplicating the old one. This shape will be used to make the button darker when pressed. Essentially, it will be used as a dark overlay over the button. So I will call this new shape overlay. We don't really need it to have any text, so I will remove that. I'll also change the fill to a different color, light gray, and make it transparent so that we can see the shape behind it. I'll also change the stroke color to gray. Let's place the new shape over the button like this. It is a bit too dark, so I'll make the background a bit more transparent. Finally, I just have to connect the pressed variable to the visibility attribute of the overlay shape like this. When I change the pressed variable, the overlay shape will appear and disappear, changing the design of the button. This pressed variable is also turned into a parameter of the drawing method. It will tell the method whether it should draw the button pressed or not. This is how we integrate all this into your Xcode project. I'll switch to Xcode and create a new project. I'll call it Variables Basics. Now let's go to the storyboard and add a new UI view here. Now let's create a new subclass of this UI view called ButtonView. Okay, remember to change the class of this UI view that we previously created to ButtonView. This is the ButtonView that we will use to draw the button. For this, we have to put the code generated in paintcode somewhere here. let's switch to Paint Code and Style Kit. By the way, we have a separate tutorial that shows how to use style kits. I'll now export the style kit to the Xcode project I just created. Next, let's add the style kit files to my project. Okay, so now I can import the style kit in my button view implementation. To draw something, we'll need to override this drawRect method. Inside, we just call the drawRateButton method on the StyleKit class. Let's compile this. And here's our button. Now, let me add some interaction. First, I will add a new property to this class. It will be a bool property called isPressed. I will also add some interaction code that will automatically set the isPressed property when the UI view is touched. Now I'll change the parameter that I'm sending to the drawRateButton method from the yes constant to the actual value of the isPressed property. Let's test this out. And it works! Next, I'd like to change the title of the button to thanks after it has been pressed. I will add a little title property here, and then use the title property as the parameter of our drawing method. Let's also set the value of the title property to something sensible in the awakeFromNib method. When the touches end, we'll set the title to thanks. Let's try this out. That's it. Thanks for watching.